हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज। आई होप यू आर परफेक्टली फाइन। गुड मॉर्निंग गाइज, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। फटाफट ज्वाइन कीजिए। गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज, गुड मॉर्निंग गाइज, गुड मॉर्निंग। कैसे हैं आप सब लोग? आर यू गाइज परफेक्टली फाइन, यस और नो? सब लोग मजे में? सो टिल नाउ आई होप यू हैव क्लियर ऑल योर डाउट। Today we are going to complete the force on Summer's body as I already told you in my yesterday class. So today we are going to complete the force on Summer's body part. That means the topics which are remaining is nothing but the vortex shedding, Magnus effect, and then last numericals. So that is the target for today, guys. That is the target for today, guys. So let me start the class. Once again, I am saying good morning to all of you. And I hope you guys are sharing this lectures with all your friend and classmate, those who want to learn fluid mechanics. They please share, because you know that these lectures are completely free, and I want all of the students all throughout the India. They get benefit from this, and that's our motto. That is our motto also. Chal. So let me start, guys. You all guys are well known that my name is Mrigang Saurabh, expert in GATE, ESC, and other technical exam for subjects like environmental engineering, fluid mechanics, open channel flow. Now I'm taking classes for environmental science branch also. And this month, or maybe at the last of this month, I'm going to announce the next subject which I'm going to start. So then the next subject is also going to come. So you all guys keep learning, keep sharing, and hamesha apne passion ki taraf bhagiye. Hamesha what you want to get, that has to be very very clear in your mind. Chaliye, in that your preparation, if you want any help or any guidance, don't forget to use this code MRI10 if you are going for the Unacademy Plus subscription. And with that, if I'm sharing any PDF with you, whether it's a class notes or any other thing, this MRI10 will be the code. Okay? Chal, let me proceed, guys. Next two. Now you know that in a plus, first thing is what? The first benefit in a single line, if I have to tell about the plus is only for those students who want to crack GATE or ESE with a good rank, then go for plus. If you want to get decent, like 30-40 marks, that is of no use basically. But if you want to just crack the GATE, in that case YouTube will be also okay. That means if you are going for one or two subject, YouTube is okay. YouTube is very good for that. But if you are going for the complete 14 subject in a package way, in a complete way, in a proper way, in that case you have to go for plus. That is the best opportunity for you guys, with a nominal price. And prices also, you can see, for 12 month it is around somewhere 2200 per month, for 18 month it is around 1900 per month, and for 24 month it is around 1600, very very less, 1600 per month. So in that 1600 per month, you are having access of all the subject, not only my lecture. You will get access for all the faculty, and you know that on an academy we have top class faculty from all over India. All the top educator are now in Unacademy. You guys are well aware of that. Chaliye. So, GATE aspirants, this is the Facebook group. You guys are well aware of this. And regarding this payment option, I also want to tell you that now we have also you can pay also through EMI option. You can pay through Bajaj cardless EMI option. So, aapke paas EMI option bhi hai, bachcho. Aisa nahi ki aapke paas EMI option nahi hai. So in that case, those guys who are not able to pay at a time, they can go with the EMI option also. Now regarding this Telegram channel, that is Unacademy GATE and ESEC channel, here you will get all the class notification as well as the class notes, which you can use it for your preparation. So don't forget to join this. And this is my profile link. This is my profile link, which you can see right now. This is my profile link. In this profile link, you have to just put this link on Chrome or something. You will get my profile. There you will get all the free special classes, whether it is a workout session which I have taken for fluid mechanics, or whether it is a workout session which I have taken for environmental engineering, or if I am taking a live test for you guys, you will be the first person to get notified of it. So click on it, put this link on Chrome or any other browser, or directly through app you can find out. You can just search my name, just download the Unacademy Learning app, search my name, and in the profile section you will find all the special classes, all the complete free special classes for you guys. So go and check out. Chali. So now let me start the today's topic. Let me start the today's topic to all of you. Let me start the today's topic for all of you. Let me start the today's topic for all of you guys. So yesterday class I have seen some of you guys are commenting in live chat, sir, we want a perfect definition. We want a perfect definition of what? For drag force and the lift force. Drag force and the lift force. Okay, we'll go with that. I will just give you some lines regarding drag and lift force that you can note it down. Chalo. So first of all, I will give it for FD. First up, I am giving for FD. F is nothing but the force due to pressure in the direction of fluid motion, plus force due to shear stress in the direction of fluid motion. Similarly if you write it for FL, it is nothing but force due to shear stress in the direction perpendicular to fluid motion. I don't think so anybody will have any problem now. Maine aapko likhwa diya. As I told you yesterday also, this drag force and lift force is coming because of two forces. One is the normal pressure force. Second is the shear force. Second is the shear stress, that part. So in that case, this FD and FL is coming. So jab direction of fluid motion ke along ki baat ho rahi hai, in that case, drag force will come. If direction perpendicular to the fluid motion, if that we are talking about, in that case, the lift force will come. Yeah, I hope it is clear to all of you. Kisi ko is baat se koi problem hai, to bataiye. Fatafat note kar lijiyega aap sab log. You guys can note it down, dear. Chalo, note kar liya sab logon ne. Chalo, we are going to the next topic now. Write down the next topic, that is nothing but vortex shedding. वॉर्टेक्स शेडिंग, वॉर्टेक्स शेडिंग। चलिए, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू द डेफिनेशन पार्ट ऑफ दिस, थ्योरेटिकल पार्ट ऑफ दिस। यू गाइस हैव टू जस्ट सिंपली राइट डाउन एंड देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू ऑल्सो व्हाट इज एक्चुअली दैट वॉर्टेक्स शेडिंग इज। पहले लिख लीजिएगा, देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू। पहले सब लोग लिखिएगा, आराम से सब लोग लिखिएगा। When a submerged body is present in the path of freely flowing fluid, path of freely flowing fluid, based on the changes in the Reynolds number, changes in the Reynolds number, type of body and its orientation on the rear side of, sirf likhe jayega, I know you guys are not getting anything, bas likhte jaiye, on the rear side of, on the rear side of the object, on rear side of object, vortices are formed, vortices are formed, vortices are formed, discontinuous formation of I am going to tell you a complete wide application. मैं आपको बहुत सारे real life example भी दूंगा, तो पहले इस बात को ध्यान से लिख लेना, because last video में आप लोगों ने बोला सर आप theory नहीं लिखवाते, तो मैं पहले इसलिए आपको theory लिखवा रहा हूं, अब मैं इसको समझाऊंगा भी बहुत ही डिटेल में, ध्यान से समझना बच्चों सब लोग। This continuous formation of vortices is known as vortex shedding. वॉर्टेक्स शेडिंग, समझिएगा, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल समझिएगा, दिस वॉर्टेक्स शेडिंग विल अकर मोस्टली इन अ ब्लफ बॉडी, मोस्टली इन अ ब्लफ बॉडी। सो आई एम ट्राइंग टू शो यू द ब्लफ बॉडी डायग्राम। दिस इज योर बॉडी, दिस इज ऑब्जेक्ट और बॉडी, व्हाट एवर यू से, I'm just showing the fluid streamlines. I'm just showing the fluid streamlines. This is the body. So what will happen? What will happen if this body is not a streamline body? In that case, what will happen? Here you will find some vortices are formed. And that is going ultimately going in this direction now. So this vortices which is formed, that's something we call as vortex shedding. That's something, the continuous formation of vortices is something we call as vortex shedding. अब आप लोग पूछोगे कि सर ये स्ट्रीमलाइन बॉडी में क्यों नहीं हो रहा? बिकॉज इन स्ट्रीमलाइन बॉडी यू आर अलाउइंग दैट वाटर टू गेट अटैच विद द सर्फेस एंड देन पास ओवर दैट बॉडी, पास थ्रू दैट बॉडी. सो दैट इज द ब्यूटी. बट इन अ ब्लफ बॉडी व्हाट यू आर गिविंग, दिस एरिया इज रिमेनिंग ना, दिस एरिया इज रिमेनिंग. दोनों साइड से आपका क्या हो रहा है, दोनों साइड से वॉटर आएगा एंड इट विल गेट रोटेट. इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू विजुलाइज इट, आपने ड्यूरिंग रेनी सीजन, आप सब लोग ने रेनी सीजन में जो आपका रिवर का ब्रिज होगा, रिवर का जो ब्रिज होगा, नियर बाय रिवर ब्रिज, गो टू दैट रिवर ब्रिज एंड चेक द डाउन स्ट्रीम पार्ट ऑफ दैट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये आपका ब्रिज है, दिस इज योर ब्रिज, फ्रॉम दिस साइड द रिवर इज कमिंग. सो डोंट लुक इन दिस साइड, लुक इन दिस साइड. यू विल फाइंड सो मेनी चकड़ी. हम लोग बचपन में उसको चकड़ी बोलते थे. आई डोंट नो व्हाट यू गाइज आर टेलिंग, बट दैट समथिंग वॉर्टेक्स मोशन ऑफ दैट वॉटर यू विल फाइंड. इज दैट क्लियर? दैट समथिंग वॉर्टेक्स मोशन ऑफ द वॉटर यू विल फाइंड. That motion I am talking about, dear. Is it clear to all of you? That vortex, the water movement, the continuous movement of the water, it will be a circular motion. So that vortex which is formed because of that, that continuous vortex formation we call as vortex shedding. The continuous vortex formation we call as what? Vortex shedding. So I don't think so anybody will have any other doubt regarding this, ki vortices kya hote hain, how it form, in what type of body it will form. I think all the question is answered now. You can copy this thing also, because now I'm going to give you something more. Look at here, yahan pe. So if continuous vortex are formed, at certain range of Reynolds number, the body undergoes lateral vibration I will tell you what is that. The frequency associated with this vortex shedding, with this vortex shedding of lateral vibration, of lateral vibration is denoted as N and described by a non-dimensional parameter known as, very important point is that is known as Struhal number. That is known as Struhal number. अब इस बात को समझना. What happens now? If the vortex are continuously formed, that you can see in the previous diagram, in that case, dear, there will be some, at a particular range of Reynolds number, we have seen some lateral vibration. So, आपने देखा होगा जो आपका ब्रिज है वो थोड़ा सा वाइब्रेट करता है कभी कभी. That vibration is what? It is nothing but the lateral vibration. It is nothing but the lateral vibration. And that vibration, every vibration will have some frequency. And that frequency which is associated with this vortex shading, that's something we are denoted with N. And it is described by a non-dimensional parameter. That's something we call as Struhal number. बहुत ही प्यारा सा फॉर्मूला उन्होंने दिया था, बहुत ही प्यारा सा फॉर्मूला दिया था. देखिएगा यहां पे, S इज इक्वल टू एन डी बाय यू इनफिनिटी. बहुत ही प्यारा फॉर्मूला है, बहुत ही प्यारा. दैट S इज विल बी इक्वल टू एन डी बाय यू इनफिनिटी. यू विल हैव डाउट सर, व्हाट इज S? दैट इज नथिंग बट द स्ट्रूहल नंबर. What is D? That is nothing but the diameter of object. Diameter of object. Next thing is the U infinity. Free stream velocity. Free stream velocity. And N is nothing but the frequency associated with vortex shading. Frequency associated with vortex shading. Frequency associated with vortex shading. So you got that formula, S equal to ND upon U infinity. ND upon U infinity, where N is nothing but the frequency associated with the vortex shading, D is nothing but the diameter of the object, and the U infinity is nothing but the free stream velocity. Free stream velocity. I hope it is clear to all of you. I hope it is clear to all of you, dear. सबको ये बात समझ में आई होगी. चलिए. Now some formula, more formula I am going to give you, especially for cylinders. Basically for cylindrical structure, you can say we have some particular formula. That's something I'm going to tell you. First one, when RE is greater than 1000, your S will be directly equal to 0.21. remember this point, many time it will get asked. Next thing, if RE is less than 1000, your S will be equal to 0.21 minus 20 upon RE. 20 upon RE. Now you guys must be thinking, sir, what is the RE? What formula we have to use? So rho VD, same formula. Rho V here, it is a U infinity into D upon mu. So complete detail of all the formula which I have given to you, rho V D upon mu. So in here it will be rho U infinity into D upon mu. अब यहाँ पे beauty बताऊँगा. Now I am going to tell you the beauty of this vortex shading. ये तो आपने theory वाला part पढ़ा. अब देखो इसका beauty क्या है. Because of that vortex, there will be some frequency. Which is formed. That frequency which is generated, because of the vortex shading, the vibration is occurring, and that vibration is having some frequency. If that frequency of that vibration is going to match with the natural frequency of that body, it is going to match with it, because her body ka ek apni thodi vibration to hoti hai. Aur for example samajh ga ki agar uski vibration ki ek frequency hai, if that frequency is getting matched with the frequency which is generated because of the vibration, and that vibration is because of what? It is because of the vortex shading. Agar dono match ho gayi, if they are matching at that point, that frequency we call as resonance. That frequency we call as resonance frequency, or that condition we call as resonance. Is that clear to all of you? Or what you will find, जब आपकी वॉर्टेक्स, जब आपकी जो फ्रीक्वेंसी बिकॉज ऑफ द वॉर्टेक्स शेडिंग एंड द नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी, व्हेन दैट बिकम्स इक्वल, In that case, you will find a sound which is coming. That sound, that vibration sound is why? Because, for example, take this body. Take this body. Now, this body is having some particular vibration. This body will have some particular vibration. But if you are giving some vibration near to that, and that vibration direction is matching. So, what will happen? This vibration will be more. This vibration will be like this. This vibration will be like this. In that case, what will happen? In that case, what will happen? You will find some sound. And that is the reason in during rainy season or something, you will find that the river is, that bridge is making some sound like thak, 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 thak. It is like at every girder, you will find that sound. At every girder, you will find that sound. Did you got that? Have you heard that sound while crossing through a bridge? Have you heard that sound while crossing through a bridge? Aap log ne dekha ya nahi dekha bacha? Yes or no? You guys have seen that or not? You guys have seen that or not? I'm asking to all of you, dear. Kya aap log ne wo cheez dekhi hai? Have you guys seen that? Heard? Dekha to aap bolo matlab आप लोगों ने आवाज सुना है? Have you heard that voice? Definitely आप लोगों ने सुना होगा. Definitely आप सब लोगों ने सुना होगा. Definitely. Now same thing I am going to give in a written format to you. That when vortex actually मैं recorded में लिखने वाला part avoid कर रहा था क्योंकि फिर आप लोग ना यहाँ पे इंटरेक्ट मेरे से नहीं कर पा रहे हो अच्छे से. एंड दैट इज द रीजन मैं नहीं चाहता था मैं थ्योरी वाला पार्ट दूं. बट यस, लास्ट क्लास में आप लोगों ने बहुत मैसेज किया है कि सर डेफिनेशन वाला पार्ट बोलिए. सो इन दैट केस मेरे को थ्योरी लिखवाना पड़ेगा. आई डोंट हैव एनी अदर ऑप्शन. व्हेन वोर्टेक्स शेडिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी बिकम्स equal to the natural frequency, becomes equal to the natural frequency, then resonance will occur and body will make a sound. And body will make a sound. And the body will make a sound. And the body will make a sound. I hope it is clear to you. I hope it is clear to you. Now, one more thing I am giving to all of you. One more thing I am giving to all of you. Vortex shedding frequency. Vortex shedding occurs mostly in bluff body. In bluff body. The vortex shedding frequency mostly occurs in a bluff body. चलिए अब एक real life example आपको बताता हूं जो आपके एकदम कान खड़े कर देगा. Very, very important real life example. Bahut hi jyada important. It's very, very important for you. It's very, very important for you. Have you guys heard that during around 18th century in a British ek pul jo hai usme crack aa gaya tha. While the army is doing march past on that. In that case, what happens? We got some crack in that river bridge. Why that crack comes? Is it because of the Bahubali? Is it because in that army some Bahubali is there? No, dear. What happens with same this vortex shedding frequency happened. In that what happens when army is doing this march past? Na, wo march past karte hain. They are having some frequency. Ek proper flow mein jaate hain. और जब वो फ्लो आपके रिव आपके जो ब्रिज है उसके फ्रीक्वेंसी मैच कर रहा है बिकॉज ऑफ द मोशन इफ दैट फ्रीक्वेंसी विच इज जनरेटेड if get matched with the natural frequency of that river bridge, in that you will find the crack in the river bridge. For example, come back again, same body. You know that every body is having some vibration, and if you are designing a river, definitely you consider some vibration in the design process. But that vibration will be what? Up to this much you have considered, na? Up to this much. Itna vibration aap consider kar rahe hoge. But if army is doing march past, and because of that the frequency which is coming, and that is matching with the natural frequency of that bridge, in that case this bridge will go like this. Idhar bhi jayega, idhar bhi jayega, idhar bhi jayega, idhar bhi jayega. The vibration is getting more. Because kya hua? अब आपका जो फ्रीक्वेंसी जो आपकी फ्रीक्वेंसी एक्स्ट्रा फ्रीक्वेंसी कहां से आ रही थी? बिकॉज ऑफ द मार्च पास जो आपका एक फ्रीक्वेंसी बनी, दैट आल्सो गेटिंग मैच्ड. और जब दोनों मैच कर जाएगा तो दिस बॉडी कैन रेसिस्ट दिस मच स्मॉल वाइब्रेशन, बट दिस बॉडी कैन नॉट रेसिस्ट दिस मच बिग वाइब्रेशन. इन दैट केस व्हाट यू विल फाइंड, यू विल फाइंड क्रैक इन दैट बॉडी, यू विल फाइंड क्रैक इन दैट बॉडी, एंड दैट इज द समथिंग व्हिच यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. किसी को इस बात से कोई प्रॉब्लम, तो आई एम गिविंग यू रियल लाइफ एग्जांपल एंड आई एम राइटिंग आल्सो फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. इंसिडेंट इंसिडेंट अकर इन 1831 इन ब्रिटिश. What was the incident? Crack in the river bridge. Crack in the river bridge when army is marching. When army is marching, in that case we got some crack, and that is a real life example of the vortex shedding. So I don't think so anybody will have any problem in this. Kisi ko is part mein koi bhi problem hai to batao. I hope aapne note bhi kar liya hoga. I hope you guys have noted also. Sabne note kar liya, kuch doubt hai to batao. Main wait kar raha hu. I know even it's a recorded session. But I always wait for you guys. मैं हर टॉपिक के बाद आपके लिए वेट करता हूँ कि आपके सवाल क्या हैं, आपके डाउट्स क्या हैं, आप डिस्कस कर लो. बिकॉज अगर सवाल डिस्कस नहीं होगा ना, देन यू विल स्टार्ट मगिंग अप द कंसेप्ट. और कंसेप्ट को मगअप करना सबसे बड़ी भूल होती है. एज एस्पिरेंट्स, इट इज द बिगेस्ट मिस्टेक यू गाइज विल डू. बिकॉज हियर इट्स अ 14 सब्जेक्ट. इफ यू स्टार्ट मगिंग अप ना, इट इज डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू टेक केयर ऑफ ऑल द कंसेप्ट. इज दैट क्लियर? So don't ever try to mug up any concept. Don't ever try to mug up. Always try to understand it. Is that clear? Chalo. Now we are going to the next topic. That is again a very, very beautiful topic for you. That's something we call as Magnus effect. Chalo. Isme aapko main theory nahi bataunga. Aap theory likhte time bored ho jate ho, I know. So I'm not going to tell you the theory. I'm just going to tell you the explanation part here. Dhyan se samajhna sab log. Everybody just be careful. draw this diagram carefully. Draw this diagram carefully. Draw this diagram carefully. To all of you I'm telling. Very very important concept I'm going to tell you. बहुत ही ज्यादा काम आएगा ये आपको. Till then. What you guys can do. You can tell me the circulation formula. I have given you circulation formula. You guys can tell me that. Circulation formula. This point it is A, this point it is B. This point it is A and this point it is B. चलिए बहुत ही प्यारी बातें करेंगे, बहुत ही प्यारी बातें करेंगे. You have to look all the diagram, you have to look all the diagram and focus it here. Now in the first diagram, everyone look it in the first diagram. ध्यान देखिएगा in the first diagram. प्यार से देखिएगा सब लोग. इन अ फर्स्ट डायग्राम नाउ दिस बॉडी इज मूविंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन विद अ वेलोसिटी वी. एक पर्टिकुलर वेलोसिटी से वो बॉडी मूव कर रही है. सो अगर आपकी बॉडी इस साइड आ रही है, अगर आपकी बॉडी फॉर एग्जांपल दिस डायरेक्शन इट इज ट्रैवलिंग, सो योर एयर फ्लो विल बी व्हाट इन अपोजिट टू दैट. योर एयर फ्लो विल बी अपोजिट टू दैट. अगर आप आगे जाते हो साइकिल से तो आपको हवा आपके अपोजिट जाती है, हवा आपके अपोजिट जाती है. सेम थिंग आई एम शोइंग विद द this blue lines, same thing I'm showing with the blue lines. So that blue line is showing you the air which is going in opposite direction. If you are going in this direction, if you are going in any other direction, the air will go in a opposite direction. Your air will go in a opposite direction. Is that clear? So jab air aapko opposite direction mein jayega bachcha, when that air will go in opposite direction, and I will ask you at point A and B, two points I have denoted at point A and B, whether at that point the velocity will be same or different. It will be same. क्योंकि आपको ऊपर में और नीचे में दोनों साइड में कोई सिर्फ आपकी बॉडी सिर्फ मूवमेंट कर रही है. कौन सी? ट्रांजिशनल मोशन हो रही है. द बॉडी इज गोइंग ओनली इन द ट्रांजिशनल मोशन. एंड इन दैट केस डियर वॉट इज दैट? योर वी ए विल बी इक्वल टू वी बी. आपका वी ए एंड वी बी आर सी. वी एंड वी बी आर सेम. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन द Bernoulli equation, you can say PA is also equal to PB. But the pressure at that both point are also equal. I don't think so anybody will have any problem. Even though if you have any problem, you can ask me after completing all three cases. Ek bar aap pura teen cases dekh lo, and then you can ask me doubt also. I will be waiting for you guys to answer all your doubt. To aaram se pehle note kar lo. Chalo, second case. Now, this body is moving in this direction with a particular velocity, v. But with that, this body is rotating also. मतलब हमने क्या किया? इस body को देखो, ऐसे rotate करके छोड़ दिया. Take a ball and rotate, give a spin to that ball. So in that, if you are giving some spin to the ball, that body is going in the transitional motion. The body is doing some transitional motion also, and body is doing some rotational motion also. वो रोटेशनल मोशन भी कर रहा है. सो इन दैट केस नाउ इन दिस केस वेदर योर वी एंड वीवी विल बी सेम और डिफरेंट. Whether your VA and VB will be same or different, I'm asking to all of you dear. आपका VA और VB same होगा या different होगा? And what about PA and PB also? About this case, it will be same or different here? It will be same or different? Look at here. Just talk about the VB part. Just talk about the VB part. आपकी body कैसी घूम रही है? For example, this body. Look at this body. Your body is moving in this way. So talk about this part. If your body is moving this way, the air which is going, it will help that air na. वो air को क्या करेगा? और ज़्यादा अपने साथ लेके जाएगा. क्योंकि body उसको help करेगा ना. In the motion of the air, the body will help at this point. You guys have to focus at this point. At this point, you will find that it is helping. अगर आपको ये देखो, ये layer है आपका. So it is helping because your body is moving in this direction. So it will give you some help. And because of that, now if you compare at A point, अब A point पे कैसी है आपकी? आपका air जा रहा है इस direction में, but आपकी body जा रही है इस direction में. That means if your air is going in this direction and body is going opposite to that, In that case, at the A point, the rotation of body will not support. The rotation of body will not help the air movement. In that case, dear, the velocity at point V will be more. Very good. I hope you guys got it. I'm again repeating this thing. Take example of this body, and this body is rotating like this. Is that clear? It is rotating in a clockwise direction. So agar aap body rotate kar raha hai, saath mein aise move bhi kar raha, there is a transitional motion also going on. So air कैसे जाएगा? नीचे से जाएगा, इधर से पास करेगा यार. So about this point, if you see that air is going in this direction and your body is also rotating in that direction, only. So at the B point, what you will find, the body is helping some fluid layer to pass. So in that case, here the speed will be a little bit more. Now come to the A part. Now A, what is happening? Air is again moving in this direction only because your body is going in this direction, so air will go definitely opposite to that. But now what about body? It is rotating in clockwise direction. So this air direction is this much, this in this direction, and your body is rotating opposite to that, So in that case, dear, aap dekho yahan pe, ye aapka air kidhar ja raha hai? This air is going in this direction and your body is just opposite to that. So in that case, at the point VB, the speed will be more, and the point A, the speed will be less. So you know that again, if you apply Bernoulli equation, you will find that wherever the velocity is less, pressure will be more. So here VA is VA in the VA part. In the VA part, velocity is what? Less as compared to the VB. So here the pressure will be more at VA as compared to PB. So PA will be more as compared to PB. I don't think so anybody will have any problem. Once again, I'm asking to all of you. किसी को अभी भी कोई problem है तो बिल्कुल बताओ बच्चों, डरो मत. Now come to this point. At the third case, this time you guys will tell me, what about VB and VB? And what about PA and PB? Just opposite here. Now here at the up point, this time rotation, what we are doing? This time rotation is in this direction. Anti-clockwise direction. So now come to that. Ab yahan pe dekho, aapki body idhar move kar rahi thi, air to abhi bhi idhar hi move kar raha hai. But this time body is not going like this. It is an anti-clockwise direction. So at this point, at B point, you will find that it is the air flow and the body movement is opposite to each other. So in that case, here the VB will be less and VA will be more. And opposite to that, PA will be less and PB will be more. So that means the pressure at B point will be more and pressure at A point will be less. Now dekhiye iska beauty, sab log dhyan samajhiyega, beauty. Now, if you see that pressure at second stage, aap yahan dekhiyega, second stage pe dekhiyega, upper pressure, upper part of the pressure is more as compared to the lower part. In that case, this body will move in what direction? This body will move like this. The body will move like this. It is going to bend towards the downward, towards the ground side. And if you come to the third part, third case, this was the first case. If you come to the third case, what you will find that कि आपकी बॉडी का नीचे प्रेशर ज्यादा है एंड ऊपर प्रेशर कम है. पीबी इज मोर एंड पीए इज लेस. सो इन दैट क्या होगा, आपकी बॉडी किधर जाएगी? इट विल गो अपवर्ड. सो दैट मींस व्हाट यू गॉट जब आप क्लॉकवाइज करके फेंकते हो. अगर आप क्लॉकवाइज करके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू कैन गो ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द टेरेस, लाइक सेकेंड फ्लोर और थर्ड फ्लोर पे जाना, और आप ये चीज करके देख सकते हो. यू कैन डू ऑल्सो इन योर होम ऑल्सो. गो टू द थर्ड और फोर्थ फ्लोर और इन योर होम. आप चारवीं या पांचवीं मंजिल पे जाइए, वहां से एक बास्केटबॉल को जस्ट सिंपली थ्रो कर दीजिए. सिंपली जस्ट थ्रो दैट विदाउट गिविंग एनी रोटेशन. तो आप देखना वो क्या करेगा, नीचे तुरंत सेटल हो जाएगा. एग्जैक्टली वो नीचे सेटल हो जाएगा. बट अगर आप उसको एक स्पिन देके छोड़ दो. सो इफ यू आर गिविंग ए स्पिन ऑफ व्हाट, इफ यू आर गिविंग ए स्पिन ऑफ एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन, तो आपको देखना वो जो बास्केटबॉल है वो एग्जैक्टली वॉल के पास नहीं गिरेगा. वो नीचे जो आपका बॉटम ऑफ द वॉल है उससे थोड़ा दूर गिरेगा. तो उसकी डायरेक्शन कुछ ऐसी रहेगी. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू शो इट, दिस इज योर टॉप ऑफ द बिल्डिंग. यहां आप खड़े हो, हियर यू आर स्टैंडिंग. और आपने क्या किया, एक बॉल को ठोकिया विदाउट एनी रोटेशन. ये बॉल क्या होगा, सिंपली यही गिर जाएगा. It will be simply here. This is without rotation. Now in a second case, if you are giving some rotation, and that too, if you are giving some anti-clockwise. So just now you have seen that in anti-clockwise rotation, this body will go upward. तो ये जो motion होगी ना वैसे होगी. देखिए, this motion will be like this. और फाइनली जाके कहीं तो गिरेगा ही वो बेचारा. नाउ अगर आप इसको क्लॉकवाइज करके दोगे तो इसकी बॉडी की मोशन कैसी होगी? दिस बॉडी मोशन विल बी लाइक दिस. Is it clear to all of you? तो ये जो motion of the body change हो रही है ना, this motion of the body which is changing ना, it is in this case it will be anti-clockwise. This case it will be clockwise. And in this case it is no rotation. Or no spin, you can say. No spin. So I hope you got this point. Nobody will have any doubt regarding that. You can ask your doubt. If you are having any other doubt, you can ask me. अब आप लोग मेरे से सारे doubt पूछ सकते हो. You can ask me your doubt. अगर आप में से किसी के कोई doubt है तो आप बिल्कुल पूछिए, आराम से पूछिए, कोई जल्दीबाजी नहीं है. You can ask all your doubt. If you want me to repeat, वो तो मैं कर नहीं सकता, but फिर भी मैं आपके doubts जरूर ले सकता हूं. So please बताइए. चलिए, so मैं आपको थोड़ा और बताता हूं, कुछ और बताता हूं मैग्नस इफेक्ट के बारे में, थोड़ा और ब्यूटीज का एक्सप्लेन करता हूं आपको, कुछ और चीजें क्लियर होंगी आपकी. चलो देखो, I'm just showing you a structure similar to a plane, aeroplane you can say. So if that aeroplane is moving in this direction with a particular velocity v, and all the layer of fluid is going like this. All the layer of fluid is going like this. All the layer of fluid is going like this. All the layer of fluid is going like this. यहां देखिए, यहां भी एक फंडा बहुत प्यारा समझने का, यहां भी फंडा एक आपको बहुत ही प्यारा समझने का है. टेक ए पॉइंट एंड बी पॉइंट अगेन. सो इफ यू नोटिस इफ द बॉडी द अपर लेंथ अपर फॉर अपर पार्ट द लेयर हैज टू द एयर हैज टू कवर मोर डिस्टेंस द एयर हैज टू कवर मोर डिस्टेंस नाउ इन अ सेम टाइम इट हैज टू रीच द आउटर पार्ट इन अ सेम टाइम इट हैज टू रीच द आउटर पार्ट In that case, what happens now? The upper layer, the upper fluid layer will move with a faster velocity. The upper layer will move with the, because it has to travel more distance. Now, आपको दिख रहा होगा, ये distance देखिए, straight distance it is less as compared to the curved distance. So at B point, what you'll find, the fluid layer which is attached to that, it is going with a little bit slower velocity as compared to the fluid layer which is attached to the A point. In that case, VA is more than the VB. And if you know that if VA is more than the VB, PA will be less than the PB. That means at the lower point, pressure is less. At the upper point, the pressure is at the lower point, pressure is more. At the upper point, the pressure is less. So, आपको मालूम है जब नीचे high pressure, ऊपर low pressure क्या होगा? एक upward jet आपको upward exert लगेगा. And that's something we call as dear. उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? दिस समथिंग वी कॉल एज लिफ्ट. दैट समथिंग वी कॉल एज लिफ्ट. एंड दैट टाइप ऑफ लिफ्ट वी कॉल एज डायनेमिक लिफ्ट. आपका शक्तिमान भी इसी पे बेस्ड है. यू नो शक्तिमान कैसे टेक ऑफ कैसे करता था शक्तिमान? इट रोटेट्स. तो अगर आप शक्तिमान को ऐसे रोटेट कर रहे हो, इफ यू आर रोटेटिंग शक्तिमान लाइक दिस एट द अपर पॉइंट बिकॉज यू आर रोटेटिंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट ओनली ना. तो आप जब आप खुद को ऐसे रोटेट कर रहे हो यहां से, सो एट दिस पॉइंट द वेलोसिटी विल बी मोर. एट द फुट ऑफ एट द लोअर बॉटम ऑफ योर फुट द वेलोसिटी विल बी लेस. सो हियर द वेलोसिटी इज मोर, प्रेशर विल बी लेस. एट द फुट द वेलोसिटी इज लेस बट द प्रेशर विल बी मोर. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट आप देखते थे शक्तिमान क्या करता था, ऊपर उठता था, ऊपर रोटेशन करता था ना वो पहले, तो वो ऊपर उठता था. एंड देन हाउ इट इज मूविंग, दैट इज अ डिफरेंट पार्ट. सो यू गेट टू नो इवन इन हेलीकॉप्टर आल्सो. हेलीकॉप्टर में क्या करते हैं, ऊपर आपका क्या रहता है, फैन लगा रहता है. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट क्या होता है, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट फैन द एयर नियर टू दैट फैन विल हैव मोर वेलोसिटी. एंड मोर वेलोसिटी मीन्स लेसर प्रेशर एज कंपेयर टू द ग्राउंड. एंड ड्यू टू दैट द लिफ्ट विल बी देयर. इज दैट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? Due to that, the lift will be there. Is that clear to all of you? I'm asking to all of you here. क्या ये बातें समझ में आ रही है? I hope you guys are getting this part. क्या ये आपको बातें समझ में आ रही है? चलिए, तो आपको कुछ कुछ चीजें तो पहले से मालूम थी. जैसे आपको FL पहले से मालूम होगा. What is FL and what is the formula of that? मैंने आपको कल बताया था, half into CL into rho into A U इन्फिनिटी का होल स्क्वायर. एंड अगेन वन थिंग मोर, आपको मैंने सर्कुलेशन का भी फॉर्मूला बताया था, एरिया इंटू वॉर्टिसिटी. सो 2πr² into ओमेगा. सो दिस टू फॉर्मूला यू गाइज आर वेल अवेयर ऑफ. नाउ आई एम गिविंग यू सम मोर फॉर्मूला हियर, दैट इज force of lift due to circulation. And that formula you don't have to remember it always. मैंने आपको for knowledge purpose लिखवा दिया है. अभी question बहुत कम आता है इससे. Rho into u infinity into circulation into L. rho into u infinity into circulation into L. I hope it is clear to all of you. किसी को कोई भी इस बात में प्रॉब्लम हो तो बताइएगा. So till that, after this topic, we have completed the theoretical part of the force due to submerged part. Now we are switching to the numerical part. चलिए अब मैं numerical point की तरफ बढ़ रहा हूँ. Now I am going to the numerical part, dear. कुछ numericals try की जाते हैं. So this numerical, I think we guys have done it. Now you guys can try this problem. This question has been asked in GATE 2015 for 2 mark. आप सब लोग ट्राई कर सकते हो उस क्वेश्चन को. Everyone try this question. Air की डेंसिटी आपको गिवन है. Kinematic viscosity they have given you 2 into 10 to power minus 5 meter square per second with a velocity of 2 meter per second flows over the top surface of a flat plate of a length 2.5 meter. If the average value of the friction coefficient is Cf, that is given to you. That is nothing but the drag part they have given you. So total drag force इन न्यूटन पर यूनिट विड्थ ऑफ द प्लेट दे आर आस्किंग. सो आपको ड्रैग फोर्स का फॉर्मूला मालूम है. यू गाइस आर नोइंग द ड्रैग फोर्स फॉर्मूला. सीडी वैल्यू यू कैन फाइंड आउट. फॉर रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर यू हैव द डाटा विथ यू. रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर के लिए आपके पास डाटा गिवन है. यू गाइस कैन डू इट. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर यू गाइस. मैं 1 से 2 मिनट वेट करूंगा. देन आई विल सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. आई विल वेट फॉर 1 or 2 मिनट. देन आई विल सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. चलो सब लोग ट्राई करेंगे बच्चा. आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू ट्राई दिस क्वेश्चन. इफ यू आर गेटिंग एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क मी. अगर आपको कोई डाउट आ रहा होगा तो आप पूछ सकते हो मेरे को. इन अ लाइव चैट यू कैन आस्क योर डाउट. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर यू गाइज. इवन दो इट्स अ रिकॉर्डेड सेशन बट मैं आप लोग के लिए वेट कर रहा हूं बच्चा. इस बात का ध्यान रखिए और गिव योर बेस्ट इन अ प्रॉब्लम. गिव योर बेस्ट. आई नो यू ऑल विल गिव मी द आंसर. सब लोग इतना प्यारा प्रॉब्लम है और 2 मार्क्स के लिए आया था. यू ऑल गाइज विल गिव मी द आंसर. एंड इफ यू आर सॉल्विंग दैट इज द रीजन मैं ऑलमोस्ट कोशिश करता हूँ. आई ऑलवेज ट्राइज टू गिव गेट और ईएससी प्रॉब्लम टू यू इन अ क्लासरूम. बिकॉज इफ यू गाइज आर सॉल्विंग गेट एंड ईएससी प्रॉब्लम ना यू विल गेट सम कॉन्फिडेंस ऑल्सो. एंड दैट कॉन्फिडेंस इज वेरी मच रिक्वायर्ड फॉर यू. चलो. आई नो यू ऑल गाइस कैन डू इट. चलिए. आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग गिवन डाटा फॉर यू. सो रो दे हैव गिवन यू 1.2 kg per meter cube. New they have given you 2 × 10⁻⁵ meter square per second. V they have given you how much? 2 meter per second. Length also they have given you. And Cf is also given to you 1.328 root under Rex. So So everything is given to you. Everything is given to you. You know that if you want to find out FD formula, FD drag force, the formula is what? Half CD into rho into A into U infinity ka whole square. Now U infinity is given to you. That is velocity is given to you. Area you can find out. Rho is given to you. CD you need to find out. Here in a CD they have given you the coefficient of friction. So try to find out that first. CF will be equal to 1.328 √ under REX. Formula is, REX is clear, that is VL upon nu, VL upon nu. So V is 2, L is 2.5, upon nu is 2 into 10 to power minus 5. Upon nu is 10 to power 10 power minus 5. So what is the value of CF you are getting? The value of CF kitni aa rahi aapki? Somewhere around 2.656 into 10 to power minus 3 you will get. 2.656 into 10 to power minus 3 you will get. I hope it is clear to you. You can find out now directly. You can simply tell me the FD value now. Now B you have to take what? They have given you that unit width. So B you have to take 1. So top surface of the plate area will be B into length. चलो सो हाफ इंटू सी डी वैल्यू कितनी आई थी 2.656 गो बैक इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 3 चलो नेक्स्ट थिंग रो दैट इज 1.2 नेक्स्ट वन एरिया लेंथ इंटू विड्थ सो 2.5 ओनली 2.5 इंटू यू इंफिनिटी सो दैट इज 2 मीटर पर सेकेंड So 2 का होल स्क्वायर what is the FD value you guys are getting? Calculate कीजिए और बताइए. You guys will tell me the FD value now. The FD value you guys will tell me. The value of FD you guys will tell me. The value of FD you guys will tell me. Solve कीजिए और बताइए. Are you getting something around this 0.059 newton? So this will be your answer. I don't think so anybody will have any problem in this question. किसी को भी इस problem में कोई doubt है तो बिल्कुल पूछिए. If you are having any doubt in this problem, you can comfortably ask. अगर आपको इस doubt इस question में कोई भी doubt है तो आप comfortably पूछ सकते हैं. चलो 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 हाफ इंटू 2.656 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 3 इंटू 1.2 इंटू 2.5 इंटू 2 स्क्वायर सो एफडी इक्वल टू यू गॉट 0.0159 न्यूटन 0.0159 न्यूटन इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू आर नॉट बातें समझ में आई या नहीं आई इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू आर नॉट चलिए अगर ये बातें समझ में आई है तो आप सब लोग नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ट्राई कीजिए यू गाइस कैन ट्राई द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू ऑल ऑफ यू I think this question only we have done, na? Yeah. Okay. So two times this question is typed. You can go to the next question. For the velocity profile, u upon u infinity is equal to y upon delta to the power 1/7. They are asking you calculate the shape factor. चलो. फटाफट आप लोग जवाब दोगे. I know you guys will give me the right answer for this question. I'm waiting for you guys to try first. How many of you guys are trying? I want in the comment section. कितने लोग try कर रहे हो? जितने लोगों को formula याद होगा, I know you all guys will try. जिन लोगों को भी formula याद होगा. चलिए 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 चलिए, बन जाएगा बन जाएगा, सबसे बन जाएगा। फॉर द वेलोसिटी प्रोफाइल यू अपॉन यू इंफिनिटी इक्वल टू वाई अपॉन डेल्टा टू द पावर 1/7, कैलकुलेट द शेप फैक्टर एच, कैलकुलेट द शेप फैक्टर एच, कैलकुलेट द शेप फैक्टर एच, कैलकुलेट द शेप फैक्टर एच। 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 आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज टू कॉमेंट इट, आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज टू कॉमेंट ऑन दिस। कैलकुलेट द शेप फैक्टर एच, कैलकुलेट द शेप फैक्टर एच। सिंपल सा कैलकुलेशन है, सिंपल सा कैलकुलेशन है। यू नो व्हाट इज शेप फैक्टर, इफ दे आर डिनोटिंग विद एच, यू नो व्हाट इज दैट, डिस्प्लेसमेंट थिकनेस, सो डेल्टा स्टार अपॉन थीटा, डेल्टा स्टार अपॉन थीटा। सो फर्स्ट यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट व्हाट डेल्टा स्टार, फॉर्मूला विल बी व्हाट, जीरो टू इंफिनिटी, जीरो टू डेल्टा, जीरो टू डेल्टा, वन माइनस यू अपॉन यू इंफिनिटी इन टू डीवाई, 1 minus u upon u infinity into dy. चलिए, so 0 to delta 1 minus u upon u infinity, how much it is, y upon delta to the power 1/7 into dy, into dy. चलो इंटीग्रेशन करते हैं। So delta star will be equal to what? Delta minus, oh sorry, y minus 1 upon delta to the power 1/7 तो constant है, other y to the power 1/7 plus 1 upon 1/7 plus 1, with that limit will be what? 0 to delta. 0 to delta, if I am not wrong. Chalo. So delta star will be what? Y minus 1 upon, or you can write like this. This is 1/7. So 7 and 7, it will be 8. So it will be 8/7. 8/7, opposite it will be 7/8. So 7/8 delta to the power 7. Bracket y to the power 8/7, 0 to delta. Now delta star, it will put this delta, you will get what? Delta minus 7/8 delta to the power 1/7 into delta to the power 8/7 bracket minus. If you put delta here equal to 0, अगर आप y की जगह 0 डालोगे तो this value will be also 0 and this value will be also 0. So no need of writing this part, I am simply writing 0. So in that case this delta star will be equal to what? Delta minus 7/8 delta to the power 8/7 minus 1/7. So 8 minus 1, it will be 7 by 7, it will be 1. So I can take delta as common. So this will become 1 minus 7 by 8. So delta star what we got is 8 minus 7, it will be 1 by 8. So delta by 8. So we got the delta star. We got the delta star. Now we'll go to the next part. Next part, you need to find out what? Theta. That is again a complicated one. 0 to delta u upon u infinity 1 minus u upon u infinity into dy. So 0 into delta, what the value we are having? Y upon delta to the power 1 by 7. So y upon delta to the power 1 by 7. The power 1 by 7. Minus 1 minus y to the power delta to the power 1 by 7 into dy. Now write it again. 0 to delta, this will become y upon delta to the power 1 by 7 minus y upon delta 1 by 7 plus 1 by 7, it will be 2 by 7. It will be 2 by 7. I hope it is clear to up to this. I hope it is clear to all of you up to this. Is that clear to all of you? Is that clear to all of you? Into dy. Now we will integrate. Now we will integrate this. So if you integrate this 0 to delta, so after integration, what you will get here? Kya aayegi integration ke baad? 1 by delta to the power 1 by 7, that will be constant. And this y to the power 1 by 7, you will get 1 by 7 plus 1 upon 1 by 7 plus 1. Chalo. Is it plus or minus? It is minus. So put it here, minus. Now here, 1 by delta to the power 2 by 7, bracket now, y to the power 2 by 7 plus 1 upon 2 by 7 plus 1. Thoda sa complicated ho raha hai, but maja aayega. Ultimately, if you're getting the answer now, you will love this part. 1 by delta to the power 1 by 7. Into 1 by 7 plus 1, it will be 8 by 7, and that's something we can write as 7 by 8 into y to the power 8 by 7 minus delta to the power 2 by 7 into 7. So it will be 7 by 9. It will be 7 by 9 into y to the power 9 by 7. Chill. Limit 0 to delta rakh dete hain. Limit 0 to delta rakh dete hain. So I don't think so putting y will be necessary for you, because in both the section we have y. So y to aapka 0 hi ho jayega. So I will directly put delta. I will directly put delta. So delta put karke dekhte hain bachcha kya hoga. Theta equal to 7 by 8. If you put delta here, it will be delta 8 by 7 minus 1 by 7 minus, it is 7 by 9 into delta 9 by 7 minus 2 by 7. So what you are getting here, delta equal to 7 by 7 minus 1 by 7, it will be 7 by 7, so 1. So I can take this delta out, 7 by 8 minus 7 by 9. Because here also the same thing is going to be 9 minus 2, 7 by 7, so you will get delta. So ultimately delta will be equal to 9 or 8, ka kya hoga? 72, 63 minus 8, 56. So, I think it is clear now. 9 or 8 calcium, 72. So 863, 9 का आपका क्या हो गया 8856. So in that case dear to all of you, theta will be what? Delta 63 minus it will be 7/72. 7/72. That will be your theta value. Now what they are asking you? They are asking you shape factor. Shape factor. चलिए, that is delta star upon. So delta star what you got? Delta by 8. So delta star upon theta. So it will be delta by 8 upon delta bracket. We have 7/72. तो डेल्टा डेल्टा का कैंसिल हो गया 1/8 इनटू 7/72 में 72 ऊपर गया और 7 नीचे रहा, सो 9/8 = 72. सो इट यू गॉट शेप फैक्टर एज 9/7. मजा आया कि नहीं इस क्वेश्चन में? आई नो दिस क्वेश्चन इज लिटिल बिट बिग फॉर यू गाइस, यू हैव टू इंटीग्रेट टू टाइम्स, बट आई नो यू गाइस लव दिस क्वेश्चन. मजा आया होगा. एक बार आपका पूरा कैलकुलेशन वाला जो पार्ट है ना वो बहुत ही मजबूत हो गया होगा. एज वेल एज यू गॉट सम रिवीजन आल्सो फॉर शेप फैक्टर, मोमेंटम डिस्प्लेसमेंट थिकनेस और डिस्प्लेसमेंट थिकनेस. तो ये सारी चीजों के बारे में आपको मालूम हो गई होगी, मोमेंटम थिकनेस, डिस्प्लेसमेंट थिकनेस एज वेल एज एनर्जी थिकनेस, आपको वो भी याद आ गया होगा. सो दैट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन, आई होप यू गाइज लव दिस, मजा आया कि नहीं आया बच्चा, जल्दी बताना whether you guys love this question or not. If you have any doubt in this question, you can tell me. अगर आपको एक कोई भी doubt है इस question में तो बिल्कुल बताइए. I'm waiting for you guys. So if you guys are having any doubt in this question, you can tell me. We are going to the next question, dear. In a laminar boundary layer over a flat plate, the ratio of shear stress tau 1 and tau 2 at two section 1 and 2 at a distance from the leading edge such that x2 is equal to 5x1 is given by. ये तो फटाक से जवाब दोगे आप लोग, ये लोग तो आप लोग फटाक से जवाब देने वाले, बहुत ही जल्दी जवाब आने वाला है, खटाक से जवाब आएगा. आई नो यू गाइज विल गिव दिस आंसर विद इन वन मिनट. इन अ लेमिनार बाउंड्री रीजन आई हैव गिवन यू अ रिलेशन बिटवीन द शियर स्ट्रेस एंड द लीडिंग डिस्टेंस. What is that relation? You guys can tell me. जब तक आप लोग कमेंट सेक्शन में आंसर नहीं डालोगे तब तक इसका सोल्यूशन में नहीं दूंगा. आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज टू पुट दिस आंसर इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन. फटाफट बच्चों, फटाफट इन अ कॉमेंट सेक्शन में अपना आंसर जवाब दीजिए. इन अ कॉमेंट सेक्शन पुट योर आंसर इन अ कॉमेंट सेक्शन. आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज टू पुट द आंसर इन अ कॉमेंट सेक्शन. फटाक से बताइएगा सब लोग. चलो रे बाबा, आंसर आपका आ गया होगा. कई लोग मेरे को आंसर दे भी दिए होंगे कमेंट सेक्शन में, बिकॉज आई कैन नॉट सी राइट नाउ, बट आई नो कि आप लोग आंसर दे चुके होंगे. आई नो यू गाइस कैन ऑलरेडी गिव द आंसर. सब लोग आंसर दोगे यार, बहुत ही आसान है. आई हैव गिवन यू दैट tau 1 विल बी tau 1 अपॉन tau 2. आई हैव गिवन अ रिलेशन, इट इज व्हाट, रूट अंडर x2 अपॉन x1. इट इज नथिंग बट द रूट अंडर x2 अपॉन x1. दैट मींस योर शियर स्ट्रेस इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द x एंड दैट टू रूट अंडर x. So they are asking you tau 1 upon tau 2. फटाक से डाल दो यहाँ पे x2 की जगह 5, x1 upon x1, x1 x1 cancel, you got root under 5. कितनी आ रही value? What is the value you guys are getting? Oh sorry, ये वाला आपका root under 5 है. This is root under 5. तो option आपका क्या होगा? Option B. You got that option B. So tau 1 upon tau 2 will be option B, that is root under 5. I don't think so. I need to give more time for this question. We are going to the next question directly. Try this question here. Sab log try karenge is question ko. Fatta fat jawab aana chahiye. The velocity distribution for a flow over a plate is given by u equal to 0.5 y minus y square, where u is the velocity in meter per second at a distance y meter above the plate. If the dynamic viscosity of the fluid is 0.9 newton second per meter square, then what is the shear stress at 0.20 meter from the boundary? फटाफट जवाब आएगा. आई नो यू गाइज आर गोइंग टू गिव मी आंसर वेरी मच लाइक विदिन अ 2 मिनट यू विल गेट द आंसर. विदिन द 2 मिनट यू विल गेट द आंसर. फटाक से जवाब आना चाहिए, फटाक से. चलो 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 चलो, ये क्वेश्चन आपके आज के क्लास का लास्ट क्वेश्चन है बच्चा. तो आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज टू गिव मी द राइट आंसर. आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज टू गिव मी द राइट आंसर. सब लोग एक साथ राइट आंसर देंगे. और मैं देख रहा हूं लास्ट सेशन में आप लोग न्यूमेरिकल के टाइम आप लोग क्लास में एब्सेंट रहते हो. थ्योरिटिकल आप देखो, सिर्फ थ्योरी से नहीं होगा. अगर आप न्यूमेरिकल नहीं बनाओगे साथ में, यू विल नॉट फाइंड योर मिस्टेक्स. तो ट्राई टू सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम विद मी ड्यूरिंग द क्लास इटसेल्फ. कोशिश कीजिए, बनेगा. कई लोग प्रॉब्लम से डर जाते हैं. थ्योरी तो बहुत अच्छे से पढ़ते हैं, बट दे आर नॉट हैविंग दैट गट्स टू सॉल्व दैट प्रॉब्लम. अरे नहीं बनेगा तो क्या होगा? यू विल गेट टू नो समथिंग न्यू ना. So always focus in that way. Always try in that way. Chalo, 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 chalo. Simple question dear. It is very, very simple question to all of you. I just want to see koi answer batayega to maja aayega. If somebody will put the answer in the comment section, I will be most happy person in that. Because ye formula maine aapko kai baar bataya bachcha. I have told you this formula so many times. न्यूटन लॉ ऑफ विस्कोसिटी फॉर्मूला क्या होती थी? टाउ इक्वल टू म्यू इनटू डीयू अपॉन डीवाई. टाउ इक्वल टू म्यू डीयू अपॉन डीवाई. दे हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू डीयू अपॉन डीवाई. सो फंक्शन ऑफ यू दे हैव गिवन यू 0.5 वाई माइनस वाई स्क्वायर. इफ यू डिफरेंशिएट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वाई, व्हाट यू विल गेट? 0.5 माइनस 2y. सो दिस इज द टाउ पार्ट. Now, mu they have given you how much? 0.9. 0.5 minus 2 into y. Y also they have given you. What is the shear stress at the 0.2 meter from the boundary? From the boundary distance, let's say 0.2. 2 into 0.2. Kitni value aa rahi hai? Tau equal to. What is the value you guys are getting? 0.9 bracket. 0.5 minus 0.4, it is nothing but 0.09. Is that option? Yes, that option is option nothing but the option D. So you got a value that tau will be equal to 0.09 newton per meter square. You got a value, tau is nothing but equal to 0.09 newton per meter square. I hope it is clear to all of you. Kisi ko bhi is question mein koi doubt nahi hoga cha. Nobody will have any doubt in this question. I'm waiting for you guys. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay. चलिए. सब लोग यहाँ पे आइए. Now, अगर बच्चों आप लोग को हमारा सेशन अच्छा लगता हो, मजा आता है, definitely always share this link or this class link with all your friends and classmates. This is the On Academy Gate C channel. You have to subscribe if you want more content from this. And these are the things which we are providing on YouTube also. And thank you for all of you. Now, two topics are remaining for you in the fluid mechanics, especially the hydraulic machine. You can say hydraulic machine will come after the gate exam because the two topics are not important for the gate exam. So I will not discuss. I will try to discuss one of the topic in between as a special class or something, but it's not sure, guys. So I will not say that. I will discuss that part in this month specifically. Now at this time mein aapka FM class abhi ho rahi thi, that is 8:45 to 10:15 am this time. Now you will have crash course for environment. Jo aapki weekend crash course thi, now it will be shifted to this time. Aur ab aapka is time mein crash course chalega. Aaram se padho. Dekho, sirf aapki class khatam hui hai, sirf aapka lectures khatam hua hai. But still I will take some workout session. Especially for this last topic which I taught, I will take some workout session. I am going to plan a workout session for that. And with that, aap log padhte rahiye, maje karte rahiye, doubts poochte rahiye. इफ यू आर कनेक्टेड विद द फेसबुक, इंस्टाग्राम, टेलीग्राम, जहां भी कनेक्टेड हो, डाउट्स पूछते रहिए, क्वेश्चन बनाते रहिए और अच्छे से प्रिपेयर कीजिए। चलिए तो हम लोग कल मिलेंगे फिर से, बट नॉट फॉर द फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स, फॉर एनवायरमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग क्रैश कोर्स। आई होप यू गाइज आर परफेक्टली ओके विद दैट एंड थैंक यू सो मच। एंड अगेन थैंक यू सो मच ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज फॉर कॉपरेशन, बिकॉज राइट नाउ वी आर डूइंग रिकॉर्डेड सेशन, आप लोग को रिकॉर्डेड सेशन अवेलेबल करवा रहे हैं। सो आई नो हमारे लिए भी थोड़ा सा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड होता है क्योंकि हम आपसे इंटरेक्ट नहीं कर पाते। आई नो इट इज अ प्रॉब्लम फॉर यू एज वेल एज फॉर अस ऑल्सो, बट वी आर ट्राइंग अवर बेस्ट टू मेक दिस रिकॉर्डेड सेशन एज अ लाइव एंड आई नो यू गाइज विल ऑलवेज सपोर्ट अस। So, चलो विद दैट गाइस, बाय बाय, टेक केयर, आई लव यू।